Hi everyone, today we'll be creating a shader for an animated glowing material in Unity. This is great for glowing objects, especially in dark lighting, as this material was created for a group project called Terminus, a tower defense game where you have to prevent viruses from breaching the firewall. You can see the animated material in use of the play area. So, let's get started on the shader. In Unity, I've already set up two objects with the basic Unity material. It should be changed to a custom one down the line. First off, create a standard surface shader and rename it to standard emissive. We're going to be using this to render the base material. The top line here tells you where is the shader located. Right now, it's located under the custom tab, but if you want, you can change where it's located by changing this string. I'm going to remove the front custom, so it will appear directly in the dropdown list instead. We can also see that in the current material, there are already some default properties that were set up for us. However, we don't need all of them. So, comment on the glossiness and metallic properties, including all the references to them. We also won't be needing the Unity instancing support either. Instead, what we do need to add are the Unity PBS lighting for physically based shading, and render queue of geometry under the substrate tags, since we are working with an opaque object. With those set up, let's start working on the properties. We're going to start by renaming main texture to albedo, and adding in an additional alpha A to its name. This is left as 2D, as it's a 2D texture. Rename all the references of main texture to albedo too. To make the references clearer, under void surf, we're also going to rename C to albedo. At the same time, shift the color to here instead. If you have worked with 3D objects before, you might know that there are other textures that are added to make the object look more realistic. So, we are also going to add two more properties, normal and mask map textures. Normal maps handle the bumps and dents of a 3D material. As for mask map, it's quite different from the rest of the textures. Remember we commented out glossiness and metallic properties? Mask map has it covered. The different channels RGBA that makes up the mask map represents metallic, occlusion, detail mask and smoothness respectively, essentially combining four textures into one. You can also put any of these individual textures into this slot, and it will still work perfectly fine. However, if you want to include two or more of these, but do not have a mask map, then you need to have them listed as individual properties instead, like this. Next, call the type of data for each property under the subshader. To have them show up in the rendered material, copy and paste this line for albedo texture and change the property name to a mask map. Do this for normal too, but change it to fixed tree instead. Also, put the texture inside the unpack scale normal function to unpack the map with a scale of 1. Below it, assign the output O with the properties. So, O.normal is normal. For mask map, as mentioned before, assign the different channels to their respective texture. Mask map R for metallic, G for occlusion, B for detail mask, and A for smoothness. However, we don't need the detail mask, since that is only required for very closed up details of the object. Here is also where, if you have created individual channels for any of these properties, reference them here instead of mask map. Going back to Unity, you can see the properties have been updated with the ones we wrote. Add in all the textures, and you should be able to see that the material is working properly. So now, we're going to move on to the exciting part, making this material glow and animated. The glow, as you might have guessed, is handled by emission, just like a normal standard material. However, we're going to make it pulse so that it looks more organic. Add in emission for the texture, emission color for the color of the emission, and emission intensity for the base brightness of the emission. These three properties are also found in the normal material. For the pulsing, we need two more float values, emission glow for how bright to glow when pulsing, and emission glow duration for how long is one cycle of the pulse. For now, let's set the default amount to 1 for the glows and 5 seconds for the duration. As usual, write this down here. and add in the fixed fall for emission. For the output, we're going to write a formula. This is to get the color emission texture, which is then multiplied by the strength of emission. This part is in brackets and is where we're going to control the pulsing. Emission intensity for the base intensity, plus the additional glow that is added to the base intensity based on two things, the time since the level has been loaded and the duration of the glow cycle. We're also using absolute here, so that the resulting glow would never be lower than the base intensity. Let's see this in action. To make the pulsing more obvious, you can either increase the intensity or the glow based on what you need. Now, we're going to create a new shader, but this time it's an unlit shader. We're going to copy some of these components into our shader to create the passing animation, so that not all parts of the texture will glow uniformly. Copy everything under pass and paste it here, so that we render the surface shader before this. Also, add in the tag render type fade, which will utilize the transparency value from the texture that is rendered here to create an overlay on the base material. At the same time, add Z-Red on for writing to depth buffer, and blend this color 0 for a multiplicative blending time. Once again, rename the texture to scrolling mask for all the references, and create a property for this under the properties section. Before proceeding further for the code, let's make the overlay texture first. Open up Photoshop or any drawing surface that you have and create a new canvas of 1024x1024 pixels. Right click the paint bucket tool and you will see this. This is the gradient tool. But first, let me backtrack slightly. Transparency value is determined based on the grayscale of the texture, with black being opaque and white being transparent. Thus, as we want a gradient for the illumination, we need the texture to have a gradient going from darker grey or black to white. So, open up the color picker, and at the two ends, pick a darker shade. I'm going with a dark grey so that the dimmer section of the material will still have a slight glow coming through. At the center, make it white. While holding shift, when you drag your mouse down from the top to the bottom, you have this beautiful gradient. Save this as a PNG. Now back in Unity, add this to the material, and you'll be able to faintly see the gradient overlay. Now, time to make this overlay move. Back here, create two more float properties called scroll X and scroll Y, with a default value of 0.2. Add a num here too. Next, under fragment, we're going to move the UV of the texture by multiplying time.y with scroll values, and then adding it to the UV. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed. And there we go. The shader is complete. Let's take a look at our final product.